Dear students, what we consider next is steps in hypothesis testing. As we have discussed earlier, estimation and hypothesis testing are the twin branches of statistical inference. Estimation means estimation of the parameters. Using a sample, we estimate the parameters using sample statistics. The second part is hypothesis testing. How to test hypothesis about the population parameters using sample statistics. Now let us see what are the steps in hypothesis testing. The first step is formulation of null and alternative hypothesis. Formulation of H0 and H1. The first step in any hypothesis testing is formulation of H0 and H1. As I told you in the last class, before beginning any research, we must formulate hypothesis. Otherwise, the entire procedure is invalid. Now let us formulate the problem of hypothesis testing more formally as follows. Suppose that we have a random variable x with the PDF fx theta. We have a random variable x with the PDF fx theta, where theta is the parameter of the distribution. Parameter of the distribution. Now, having observed a random sample of size n, a random sample of size n from this population, we obtain a point estimator theta hat for the parameter theta. For the parameter theta, we take a sample, random sample of size n, and using this random sample, we obtain a point estimate. Since theta, the parameter, is unknown, we ask a question. The question is the estimator theta hat compatible with some hypothesized value of theta? Is the value of the estimator theta hat is compatible with a stated value of theta, say theta is equal to theta star, where compatible means sufficiently close to. Compatible means sufficiently close to. So the question is the estimate of theta hat is compatible with some hypothesized value of theta, say theta is equal to theta star, where theta star is the value of the theta stated under null hypothesis. Or it is a specific value of theta, say. So, stated differently, could not, the stated differently, could our sample have been come from a PDF fx theta, where theta is equal to theta star. So the question is whether our sample is generated from a population with the value of theta equal to theta star. And in the language of hypothesis testing, theta equal to theta star is known as null hypothesis. Theta is equal to theta star is the null hypothesis and is written as H0. As I told you, the discussion is very general, applicable in all the situations. Now the parameter is theta. Theta star is the estimated. The question is whether the sample is generated from a population with the theta equal to theta star. And theta is equal to theta star is known as H0. And it is tested against alternative hypothesis. So H0, theta is equal to theta star, tested against an alternative hypothesis, theta is not equal to theta star. Theta is not equal to theta star. Now, this H0 and H1 can be symbol or a composite. H0 and H1 can be symbol or a composite. And as I told you earlier, a hypothesis is an assertion about a population parameter. Now, the hypothesis is an assertion about a population parameter, say theta is equal to theta star. Now, this hypothesis can be symbol or composite. The hypothesis is symbol if we specify a specific value for the parameter. If a specific value is not specified, it is composite. As an example, suppose that X follows normal with the mu and sigma square. Suppose that our H0 is that mu is equal to a specific value, say mu star, and sigma square is equal to sigma square star. Specific value is suggested, a simple hypothesis. Suppose that our H0 is mu is equal to mu star, and sigma square is greater than a specific value, say sigma square star. So greater than 2 or something like that. Then it is a composite hypothesis because the value of sigma square is not specified. The value of sigma square is not specified. If the value of the parameters are specific, it is symbol hypothesis. If not specified, that is if you have expressions like a greater than, less than, etc., then it is composite hypothesis. Now, a point I want to mention and will be discussed later is that in econometrics, we always test a hypothesis known as say theta is equal to 0. Theta is equal to 0. Instead of specifying a particular value, we often test the hypothesis like this. This is known as zero null hypothesis. Zero null hypothesis. But this is not the only hypothesis which we will test. We can give any values for, we can give any values for theta. This is a test which we often use in econometrics. When you read a software output, always remember that the software output is based on this hypothesis. And if you want to give, or if you want to test other hypotheses, then you have to re-specify it. Options are available in all the softwares to test hypotheses other than this. Now, usually H0 is simple. So H0 is, say, theta is equal to theta star. Simple hypothesis. But H1, the alternative hypothesis, can take any of these forms. H1 theta greater than theta star, theta less than theta star, theta not equal to theta star. H1 can be greater than theta star, less than theta star, not equal to theta star. And remember this, all these alternative hypotheses are composites in nature. And which hypothesis we will use depends on the problem at hand. Sometimes we will use this, sometimes we will use this, often we test it, theta not equal to theta star. For example, a null hypothesis may, as an example to this, suppose that our null hypothesis is that x is normal with mu and sigma square. And suppose also that we want to test mu only. Then suppose that we formulate a hypothesis that mu is equal to 70. Tested against H1, mu is not equal to 70. Or mu is greater than 70 or less than 70. And the form in which H1 is formulated determines the critical region. The critical region. This is our alternative hypothesis. The critical region is in the right side. This in the left side. This in both sides. So the critical region, that is the location of the critical region, depends on how we formulate H1. Remember this, the location of the critical region depends on how we formulate H0. Now, to test a hypothesis, we divide the entire population into two. One is the acceptance region. The acceptance region. The other one is the critical region. There is a point I want to specify here. The point is, as I mentioned many times, for hypothesis testing, we use a test statistic. Test statistic. Suppose that it is x bar to test a hypothesis about mu. And as I told you earlier, estimators are not directly used for hypothesis testing. From the estimators, we develop the test statistics. So Z is equal to x bar minus mu by sigma by root n. Now, remember this. If x is normal with the mu and sigma square, x bar is also normal with the mu and sigma square by n. What does that mean? If x has mean equal to mu, say 100, x bar is also mean 100 because x bar is unbiased. Now, if you ask me a question, whether we are testing this parameter or this parameter, my answer is both are one and the same thing. And for testing, we use this test statistics. That this is the distribution of the test statistics. Z is equal to x bar minus mu by sigma by root n. And this is the distribution with a zero, because it is converted into Z. Converted into Z, or I can write it as, this is x bar, this distribution, x bar with the mean mu. When the mean of x bar is equal to mu, the value of Z is zero. So my hypothesis is H0, mu is equal to a specific value, is about the mean of x bar. It is also the mean of x. Mean of x bar or mean of x. This is a point which we will discuss later. Suppose that the value I specified is equal to 100. Suppose. Now this is the entire region of the test statistics. This entire area of the test statistics, here or here, is divided into two. Divided into two, highly likely under H0. It is the acceptance region. Highly likely under H0, the acceptance region. Say 95%. As an example, if alpha is 5%, 95%, then it is 2.5% here, 2.5% here. This 2.5% here and here, known as the critical region. The critical region, value of the population having very low probability to observe. Acceptance region is value of the population with a high probability to observe, given that H0 mu is equal to 100. So the entire population, when I say population, the entire distribution of the test statistics is divided into highly likely under H0 and highly unlikely under H0. If your H1 is not equal to type, the critical region is on both the tails, both the left and right tail. If your H1 is greater than type, the entire critical region is in the right side only. Otherwise, it is in the left side. So whether you have a two-tailed test, a right-tailed test, or a left-tailed test depends on how you formulate H1, the research hypothesis or the alternative hypothesis. Now, remember this, in applied, in empirical applications, the critical region is often fixed as 5%. And this is also known as the level of significance alpha. That is, the critical region is often taken as 5%. That is, in the highly likely values of the distribution is often taken as 5%, and this 5% is known as the level of significance, denoted as alpha. Denoted as alpha. Alpha is known as the level of significance. So this is the first step in hypothesis testing. Remember this, in hypothesis testing, we have a population with an unknown parameter. We formulate a hypothesis about the unknown parameter. And to test this, we use a sampling distribution and a test statistics converted into test statistics derived from the sampling distribution. The distribution of the sampling, the distribution of the test statistics over the sampling distribution is used for hypothesis testing. Remember this always. And the entire distribution is divided into highly likely under, which is 0, highly unlikely under, which is 0. The hypothesis can be simple or composites. This is the first stage in the hypothesis testing procedure. In econometrics, the highly unlikely region is often fixed at 5%. 5% is not the only value which we use. In medical sciences, it is fixed at 1%. And in some cases, we can go up to 15%, etc., depending on the circumstances that we will explain with the concrete examples later.